Good morning, and welcome to another amazing worship experience right here at Dare to Imagine. My name is Wallace.
And my name is Crystal. We are elated that you decided to join us this morning for yet another worship experience here at Dare to Imagine Church.
And you know, I'm sure that many of you, like myself, you found out about our church because someone shared the experience. So we want you to be that catalyst for someone else. So go ahead and share this experience.
Yes, share the wealth. And how can you do that? By first liking this and then sharing it with your family and your friends, dropping it in your group messages, all of that, so that people can tune in and watch what you get to watch every Sunday.
Absolutely. And of course, we want to say a quick shout out to everybody in the sanctuary and everybody watching online. So go ahead, say good morning. Let us know where you're tuning in from.
Yes, good morning, everyone. So we want to stay connected with you. So if you see someone walking around with a first time question mark saying on their shirt, we encourage you to go ahead and come up to them so they can direct you and collect some brief information from you so that we can stay connected with you.
Absolutely. And if you're watching online, just text the number you see right there at the bottom of the screen. Someone from church will reach out, get to know you, and get you looped in with everything here at D2I.
Absolutely. We had such an amazing time last Sunday at Praise in the Park. And not only was it an amazing worship experience, but we also had an iGroup picnic that was so much fun. We played games. We even played the Masked Singer, yep. Which was so much fun. I was trying to get up there and be a Masked Singer, right?
And then how about Craig and that barbecue chicken?
Hey, okay.
A1.
Craig did not come to play.
So again, we had such an amazing time celebrating our iGroups. But as you know, there is always something new happening here at Dare to Imagine. So let's get into it with our segment called
What's Happening? We want to invite you to our 9 and 11 a.m. service next Sunday, June 20th, which is Father's Day.
Hey.
So we are inviting all the fathers and father figures to come to church, just like Pastor KJ preached about last Sunday. We got to come to the church. Can't give up on the church, y'all. So why not do that by coming and join us as we celebrate our fathers and father figures here at the 9 a.m. and 11 a.m. service.
Absolutely. And I heard we got a special gift just for our father, so you definitely want to make sure you come in for that.
Yes. We love giving stuff away here.
Always.
Yeah.
And then, of course, mark your calendars. Get ready for the all-white affair coming up on August 29th. We're giving you plenty of notice so you can get your outfits ready. It's one of my favorite events of the year. Cannot wait.
It's going to be so much fun.
It really is.
Yes, that's awesome. So we encourage you right now while you still got time, because it sounds like the worship team is getting ready to kick us off, to go ahead and share this worship experience with all of your family and all of your friends so they can tune in.
And absolutely. So no matter if you're in the sanctuary or watching online, we want you to be an active participant in our worship experience. So let's get ready to celebrate our Lord this morning.
Amen.
Good morning, Dare to Imagine. We encourage you to stand on your feet and sing with us and worship with us this morning. The Lord is high above the heavens.
The Lord is high above the heavens.
And His glory above the nations.
And His glory above the nations.
I said the Lord is high above the heavens.
The Lord is high above the heavens.
And His glory above the nations.
And His glory above the nations. Is high above the heavens,
and His glory above the nations,
and His glory above the nations.
The Lord is high above the heavens,
the Lord is high above the heavens,
and His glory above the nations,
and His glory above the nations.
Hallelujah.
To express how great
for you to do. And your hand is moving right now. You are still showing up at the tomb of every Lazarus. And your voice is calling me out. And right now, I know you're able.
You won't lose.
And I know you won't lose.
I know you won't lose.
And I know never give up on you, God. Hallelujah. So many times we give up on ourselves, but God has never given up on you. You feel defeated, but God still never gave up on you. Hallelujah. I just want to say thank you for that, Father. I just want to say thank you. I just want to say thank you. Thank you, Lord, for never giving up on me. Never giving up on me. I might not do things right, but hallelujah, God, you never gave up on me. My friends may have turned their backs on me, but God never turned his back on you. Hallelujah. Through all the sin, through all this, through all that, but God never gave up on you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Because he's Alpha and he's your Omega. So we worship you, our Lord, for you are worthy to be praised. Come on and help me sing it in here. Come on. You are Alpha and Omega. We time. Let's fill this place. You are Alpha and Omega. We worship you, our Lord. You are worthy to be praised.
Come on and lift your hands and say, sanctuary. Come on, we call him Alpha and Omega. We give you all. We give you all the
glory.
All the honor and the glory.
We worship you, our Lord. You are.
Hallelujah, God. I thank you. just want to say thank you.
Never Hallelujah. Lost a battle. I mean, I love that song. It gets me every time.
Amen. It's just so powerful. And honestly, just the way the praise team has been shutting it down each
right.
and every Sunday.
Yes.
Shout out to them.
They are so, so amazing. And we hope that you have enjoyed the worship experience just as much as we have. So we are encouraging you right now to go ahead and share this worship experience with everyone that you know.
Absolutely. Put it in the group chat. Text it to your friends, your neighbors, your coworkers. You never know how this could completely transform someone's day and week. So share this experience.
Absolutely. Absolutely. And as always, we encourage you to tune into at least one or both of our services that we have at 9 and 11 a.m. It's always going to be a treat.
Absolutely. And of course, if you subscribe to our channel, you can get all of the words and all of the words to come. But today, it's all about our D2I graduates. We want to celebrate you. So whether that's pre-K all the way through college, join us for the 11 a.m. worship experience so we can continue to celebrate our graduates.
Yes, so congratulations to any and all who are celebrating graduating.
To all the students and graduates, we want to say congratulations. You made it through a challenging year, and your resilience through all the hardships is truly inspirational. Today is your day, and we celebrate you. We celebrate all of the students, especially the class of 2021.
Blessed people in the house today, the blessed in the city, blessed in the field, blessed wherever you go. Hallelujah. Come on, clap your hands, everybody. Yeah. And I need you to repeat after me. Oh, let me hear you say,
around, 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 around,
when we go. We cast out every stronghold. Sickness and poverty must cease.
For the devil is defeated.
The devil is defeated.
We are
blessed.
Hallelujah. Amen. Can y'all hear me now? We praise God so much for each and every one of you. I am just so thankful to look at y'all coming back. Amen. Come on and give God some praise today. Come on, we bless his holy name. It is a joy to be here today, and we thank God so much for you. Beloved, let's get ready now to bless God through our giving and bless God through our tithes and offerings. I want to really encourage you to give the way that I give, and that's via Push Pay. And all you have to do is to text D2I Church app to 77977. And if you haven't been here in a while, you got some making up to do. Amen. Amen. But I'm just so glad to have you back here today. Come on, our praise team is going to continue to bless us a little bit more. And then we're going to come back right in the next few seconds. Sorry about this, Noe, but I had to use your microphone. Amen. We're both vaccinated, so we're fine. Hallelujah. Come on, clap your hands, everybody.
Get back there to give y'all a hug. Amen. Who else have I have not seen? I'm looking around here. I'm kind of blinded because if this is your first time being back in worship, come on and stand so your pastor can see you. Amen. Praise God for you. Amen. Hey, Jennifer, what's up? Hey, Kia, what's happening? Oh, my God. Is that Richard? What? Oh, my God. Richard Williams is in the house. Come on and give God some praise today. Amen. Beloved, I thank God so much for you. And if you're watching online, I know you're like, I'm going to come next Sunday and see if Pastor remembers me. It may have been 15 months, but I know my people. Amen. Amen. I love you all, and I thank God that you're back. Amen. Come on and give God some praise today. If you're thankful that God is bringing us through COVID-19, then come on and give God some praise. Bless his name. Glorify him. Lift him up because he's worthy. I bet he's worthy to be praised. Well, we got this next little video to show y'all. And I'm just going to go ahead and tell y'all, I was kind of in a funk this morning. You know, pastors can't be in a funk. I know it's not a good church word, but I'm just using it with you today. But y'all coming in here today, oh my God, y'all don't even know how much y'all blessed me. To see y'all back in the chairs, oh my God, it is just such a blessing. And part of the way in which we have stayed connected to our congregation is via our iGroups. And I want you to watch this video to see how iGroups have been a blessing to Dare to Imagine.
Hey, Dare to Imagine, it's Christine, and we are here at our end of semester iGroup picnic, where we are celebrating our iGroup leaders, the participants, and everything that made this semester one to remember.
As Pastor said, iGroup started about almost 2 years ago, and so we thank you for all of your faithfulness, for your commitment, and for just wanting to help build that community that we have here at Dare to Imagine.
So today is going to be jam-packed with fun. We have food, games, raffles, guest speakers. We're going to be honoring our Leadership Academy, and we have a special game called Masked Singer that we're going to be playing with some mysterious guests. Now, for those of you who do not know about iGroups are small group communities where people get to come together and connect with like-minded individuals over a multitude of topics. So if this sounds like something that interests you, be sure to register for our next semester of iGroups at d2ic.org/iGroups.
Leaders and members, we are making $1,000 to expand the Vision Fund to support programs and initiatives at Dare to Imagine. Thank you all.
Amen. Come on, let's give it up for our iGroups. Amen. They tell me Larry Skinner's in the house. I've seen Carmen, but where's Larry? Amen. Hey, what's up, brother? Good to see you. Amen. I know that we're coming back. We praise God so much for you. Beloved, let's go ahead and give to our expanded vision. This is the way in which we reach out to our community to make sure that we have a tremendous impact. And so go ahead and give using PushPay. All you have to do is to text D2I Church app to 77977 and use the category of expand the vision.
Our God is in control, steadfast, unmovable, nothing's impossible, our God reigns forever. Somebody say,
our God is in control,
steadfast,
unmovable,
say nothing,
nothing's impossible,
our God,
our God reigns.
Stand fast, and
nothing's impossible.
If our God reigns,
our God reigns forever.
Our God
is in control.
Stand
fast,
and
nothing's impossible.
God, we thank you right now. We thank you for every gift and for every giver. God, bless these gifts and multiply them for your glory. In Jesus' name, amen.
Thank you, Jesus, for being everything we need. And more, Jesus, hallelujah. You are everything. You are all in all. Hey, Jesus. Say everything, everything,
everything.
Say everything to me. Say
you're everything to me.
Everything, say
everything.
Lift your hands and tell Jesus you're
You're everything to me.
Say, my best friend.
My best friend.
Yes, you are. You're everything.
You're everything to me.
You're my peace.
You're my peace.
In the midst of the storm, Jesus, you're everything.
You're everything to me.
Say, hope for tomorrow.
Hope for tomorrow.
Oh, you're everything.
You're everything to me.
Say, joy and sorrow.
Joy and sorrow.
Really, huh? Somebody say, Master,
Master,
let me hear you say, Savior,
Savior,
declare that he's a ruler,
ruler,
somebody knows that he's a redeemer,
redeemer,
he's your provider,
say, provider,
and he'll cover you, he's your shelter,
shelter.
And if you're sick in your body, he's your healer.
Healer.
Deliverer, deliverer.
Deliverer.
Somebody say, Father.
Father.
He's your father. He never left you, no, he
is. Father.
He's your father. Yes, he is. Show up right on time.
Jesus.
Jesus, Jesus, Jesus.
Jesus.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yes to your will, yes to your way.
Yeah.
Yes, I don't pain every day.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Reverence his name. Bow before the King. I bow before the King. Let me say, I bow
before the King.
And I reverence your name, Jesus.
I bow before the King.
Because we honor and reverence your presence.
I bow before the King.
I bow before the King.
I bow before the King.
I humble myself before a great and mighty God.
Bow before the King.
Because I don't deserve what he gives me.
Bow before the King.
But I'm thankful for what he's done for me.
Bow before the King.
I bow before the King.
Bow before the King.
Say, Master, Master.
Master.
Declare that he's your Savior.
Savior.
Your shelter in the time of storm.
Shelter.
He's your healer, healer.
Your healer.
Deliverer, deliverer.
Deliverer.
Yes, yeah. I thank you, Lord. I thank you, Lord.
Yeah.
My soul says yes, Lord.
Yeah.
Father, yes, God.
Yeah.
I'm Every knee shall bow at
Jesus.
Every tongue will confess the name of
Jesus.
There's nobody greater than Jesus. Shout Jesus, Jesus,
Jesus.
If you need him, you can call the name of
Jesus.
And he'll show up right on time. Say Jesus, Jesus,
Jesus.
Come on, wherever you are, just begin to praise him. Magnify his name. Glorify his name. He's worthy of the praise. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Father. Oh, call the name of
Jesus.
And he is your protector. Say, call the name of Jesus.
Jesus.
There is power in the name of Jesus.
Jesus.
He'll destroy the yoke if you call him Jesus.
Jesus.
And he'll loose the shackles that have you bound.
Jesus.
Say Jesus, Jesus, yeah.
Jesus.
What a wonderful name.
Jesus.
Come on, let's stand our feet. If he's everything, come on, sing it with us.
Everything to me.
You're everything to me.
Everything.
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 Come on, let's sing it together.
Hallelujah, everything.
You're everything to me.
Hope for tomorrow.
Hope for tomorrow.
If he's your hope for tomorrow.
Everything.
You're everything to me.
Joy and sorrow.
Joy and sorrow.
Yeah, joy and sorrow.
You're everything.
You're everything to me.
You're my peace.
You're my peace.
Yes, that's it.
Yes, you are. You're everything.
You're everything to me.
You're my joy.
You're my joy.
Come on, bless the name of the Lord.
Thank you, Jesus. You're everything to me.
Everything. God, we thank you right now. We thank you for your presence. We thank you for your anointing. God, we ask right now for your spirit to be with us. God, as we seek to go higher in your word, in Jesus' name, amen. Amen. If you're glad to be here, come on and bless the name of the Lord. Amen. Beyond thankful to see you here and see so many of you making your way back here to church. I have missed you all and love you dearly and thank God for your presence today. I'm in the midst of a series that we are calling Welcome Back. I'm going to be in this series probably until the end of July because I know that God is doing something mightily in the life of this church, and God's been using us over these past several months. And so today, I really want to deal with this today and talk not just about welcome back, but I want to go to Luke chapter 15. And today I'm going to deal with this early part of Luke 15. And then next week, I'm going to come back and I'm going to deal with Luke 15 again, because there's some power there in talking about the prodigal son. Next Sunday is Father's Day, and I really want to invite all of the fathers to make their way to church on next Sunday. Amen. And I'm going to be dealing with the prodigal son on next Sunday, so I hope that you invite your fathers, invite your sons, invite men to come on next Sunday. Amen. It will be beautiful just to fill up the church with all men. Amen. Won't that be a blessing? So we thank God so much for that. But listen to what the Word of God says there in Luke chapter 15, begin at verse 1. Now the tax collectors and sinners were all gathering around to hear Jesus, but the Pharisees and the teachers of the law muttered, "This man welcomes sinners and eats with them." Then Jesus told this parable. Suppose one of you has 100 sheep and loses one of them. Doesn't he leave the 99 in the open country and go after the lost sheep until he finds it? And when he finds it, he joyfully puts it on his shoulders and goes home. Then he calls his friends and neighbors together and says, "Rejoice with me. I have found my lost sheep." I tell you that in the same way, there will be more rejoicing in heaven over one sinner who repents than over 99 righteous persons who do not need to repent. I want to talk today from the subject of, I'm glad he found me. Is there anybody else who's glad that Jesus found you? Come on, put it right there in the chat. I'm glad that he found me. If there's something that I hate the most, it is losing things. In fact, many of you know by now that for over a year, your pastor has had to add some eyes to his eyes so that he can see. Yes, in fact, now I have a number of pair of glasses. I remember when I first started wearing glasses, someone said to me that you're going to have to get another pair of glasses. Matter of fact, you're going to have to buy a number of pair of glasses because you may lose them. And you know, I said to them, I said, you don't know who I am. I don't lose anything. I know where things are. My children, they know that if they use the charger for my computer, when I, in my office, when I go back to my office, it better be in the same place because I leave things in the same place. I know I do not forget things. I know where things are, and I almost kind of know what time of day something was moved, so I don't really lose things. But one day, Brother George, one day I lost my glasses. And you know, it's not like when you lose a pair of keys or when you lose a phone. If you lose a phone, then you can just go to the Apple store and buy a new phone. You know, it's kind of simple. If you have your contacts in the cloud, you can just download it from the cloud and you can erase the phone wherever that other phone may be. So I don't really get concerned about losing a phone. You know, keys are, you know, you can get another key made, you know, when you lose something. But when you lose your one pair of glasses, and when you need your glasses in order to see, it will mess you up. And I never will forget, I had lost my one pair of glasses. And when I realized that I really needed to wear glasses, Jennifer, it was when I was trying to sign my own signature and I was having trouble making out where the signature line was. That's when I realized that I needed to buy some more glasses, and that's why I've hooked up now with Warby Parker. I got all kind of glasses. I got black glasses. I got camouflage glasses. I got glasses that got a little blue tint in them. Oh, yeah, your pastor be rocking some glasses now. But I'm rocking the glasses because I am afraid of losing another pair of glasses. I'm afraid of what it will be like if I lose this pair of glasses because I know that I won't be able to see. Well, beloved, when we look here in this text, we see that Jesus is having a conversation about a sheep that was lost. And many of us, when we look at this text and we see this scripture here about this sheep being lost, that Jesus makes it abundantly clear. He says, even if there is one sheep that has been lost, then I'm going to get that sheep because that one sheep is my sheep. And beloved, I wish I had a few people in here today who could testify that you're so glad that Jesus came after you. You're so glad that Jesus did not throw in the towel. That you're so glad that Jesus gave you another chance. If there's anybody who's watching online, you ought to be giving God an emoji clap that he saved you. You ought to be giving God some praise right now that he found you. You ought to be thanking God right now that when I was lost, that he found me. And when I begin to think about being lost and thinking about this text, one of the things that has really stood out to me and stand out to me today is the fact that Jesus goes after the one because he wants us to understand that you have value, that God values you. I shared a few weeks ago about how in the text when I talked about how about the broken and the leftovers. And I talked about how God sees value in you. And when I look here in this text and I see this sheep that Jesus goes after, as he tells this parable in this text, is that what he wants us to understand
is that God values me. That's the first point I want to make this morning. Can you go ahead and put that in the chat and go ahead and share with me right now that God values me? You see, when God values you, what it really means is that God says that you're important. That when God values you, what it means is that there is something useful about your life. Is that when God values you, it means that God sees something that is of significance and of value, and therefore God will go and find the lost sheep because God wants you to understand that you have value. And that's the reason why you've been given a second chance. That's the reason why you're not dead. That's the reason why God healed your body. That's the reason why God gave you a second chance. It's because you have value. I don't care what your friends say about you, you got value. I don't care what your haters say about you, you have value. I don't care what your enemies say about you, you have value. And it's not until you start walking in your value and knowing who you are and whose you are that you can really give God some praise. Does anybody know today that God values you? I'm sharing this with you today because so many times we think that God only values rich people, that God only values those who have education. But my grandmother, God bless her soul in glory, she taught me the meaning that God values me. And it's not until you realize that all that you have is God. That all that you've got is the Lord. That you and I begin to see that God values us. It's not just that God values you, but God validates you. Oh, I wish I had a witness here today. That's the second point for today. Is that God just doesn't value you, but God validates me. See, the reason why God is so concerned about you and concerned about your family and concerned about your livelihood is because God wants the world to know that this person has been validated, that this person is good. That this person is mine. And you know, many of us, we like designer things, right? I mean, I'm looking at some of y'all. I'm looking at some of y'all. Y'all got on Burberry. I'm not going to call out your name, but I see you rocking. It looks good. I see some of y'all, you come in with your mask, and your mask will have a Chanel, or some of y'all even rock a little Gucci. I don't know if it's fake or real, but it for me, as far as I'm concerned, it's real. Amen. You're going to catch that in a few minutes. That some of us, we be rocking some stuff, and we make that thing look like it costs $1,500, but it only costs $1.50. Amen. but we like nice things, and we what makes it nice is for many of us is the fact that it has a stamp on it, that it has a symbol that says that it's been marked. And when God validates you, God is legally declaring that you are acceptable. Okay, have I got a witness here today? It's because if we look back over our lives and we look at the stuff that we used to do, but the fact that we can come into church and to give God some praise when we know what we used to be and where we used to go. The reason we can give God the praise is because what we're saying to the world is that God validated me. It doesn't matter what my past is. It doesn't matter what I used to be. What God sees is where I am right now. God has validated me. There's so many of us is that we're trying to be validated by somebody else. We're trying to be validated by people and persons and spouses and everything else. But the only validation you need is God. The only person that you need to be concerned about is what the Lord thinks about you. And that's the reason why sticks and stones, they may break my bones, but words, they will never hurt me. It's because I'm not concerned about your word, but I'm concerned about his word. And when he says, well done, thou good and faithful servant, you should only be thinking about if God validates you. And I look here in this text, and Jesus tells this parable about this lost sheep. The text says, and I want you to see this because it's powerful. Put it back up on the screen for me, please. It says in verse 3, then Jesus told this parable. Suppose one of you has 100 sheep and loses one of them. Doesn't he leave the 99 in the open country and go after the lost sheep until he finds it? Now, I started shouting as I was going over this sermon last night. It's because, do you know the difference between losing something and something that's lost? When something is lost, it means it's gone. But when you're losing something, it means that it's moving away from you. Oh my God. And the reason I get excited about this text is because Jesus does not say that we are lost, but he says that he's losing, which means that we have been walking away from God, which means we've been moving away from God. But I thank God that even when I'm moving away from him, and even when I'm going in a contrary way, that God goes after me, because God says he may be lost, but I'm not going to lose him. Oh, I wish I had a witness here today. It's because you're not lost, because God is not going to lose you. And that's why he goes after the one. That's why God doesn't give up on you. That's why you still got a second chance. It's because God's not going to lose you. Is there anybody here today who's glad that God never gave up on you? Is there anybody here glad that God never threw in the towel on you? So God, he values me. He validates me. But then some of y'all better be running across this church. You ought to mess up your carpet, put a hole in it right now. It's this third thing, that God envisions me. Oh, my God. Hey! Oh, I wish I had a witness in here today. You see, can I go ahead and help you out here? One of the things that I've discovered about shepherds is that shepherds, when they would lose a sheep, is that shepherds would go after the sheep. One, because they didn't want to lose the sheep, but also because the shepherds were not independent. They were really working for somebody else, the master. Oh, you're going to catch it in a few minutes. And so the shepherd would go after the sheep that he may have lost, because he knows that he's going to be held accountable for the one that he lost. And what I've discovered about shepherds is this, Bernie, is that shepherds, sometimes when they go and find the sheep and they see that the sheep has gotten lost, sometimes the shepherd will break the sheep's leg to teach it a lesson. Now, I know that that seems kind of harsh. It's because you're saying to yourself, why is it that a shepherd would break the leg of a sheep that it just found? Well, when I started digging a little bit more, I started to learn that sometimes shepherds will break the leg of a sheep because they want the sheep to understand that what you did was wrong. That you left the fold and you left God and that you left your shepherd. But then there's something else that I've learned about shepherds. Is that the main reason why the shepherd ends up breaking the sheep's leg is because the shepherd knows that now the sheep is dependent upon the shepherd. Oh, I wish I had a witness here today. And what happens, that's why the text says, I will carry the sheep on my shoulders. It's because what Jesus is reminding the people is that sometimes the shepherd has to break the leg of the sheep. And so therefore the shepherd will put the sheep on his shoulders. And the reason that the shepherd does that is because the sheep can't walk. But this is what happens, is that as the sheep is getting stronger, the shepherd has to carry the sheep with the rest of the herd. Can you see it? All 99 sheep are moving about, but the shepherd is carrying the sheep of the leg that has been broken on the sheep. And you know what's happening is that there's a bond that's starting to develop between the sheep and the shepherd. And so therefore, when the sheep gets well, the sheep will understand that I'm never going to leave the one who helped me get back to where I needed to be. All I wish I had a witness here today is because God has been carrying you. God has been protecting you. And God says, don't ever leave me again. It's time for you to make your way back home. I don't know about you today, but I'm so thankful to God that every now and then that God has to break me. Every now and then God has to break me down, but he carries me and he walks with me and he tells me, hey, that I am his own. I don't know who's been broken, but maybe you've been broken is because you've been away and you've gone astray. And all this time, God's been nurturing you. God's been helping you get stronger. And you trying to figure out why COVID-19 didn't take you out. It's because God has had his hand upon you. And if you are here today, I invite you now to come as we stand our feet. If you're online, or if you are here in the sanctuary, you ought to be like me. I'm glad that he found me. There's somebody here today, this morning, online. All you have to do is go right there to d2ic.org/join. Or if you are here in the sanctuary, as I catch my breath, come on and make your way. Come on and press your way. Because I firmly believe that God's been caring for you. And God's been with you. Because he wants you to make your way back to him. It's time for you to make your way back to church. It's time for you to get back into your regular weekend routine. And that's worship right here in the sanctuary, on this campus, at Dare to Imagine Church. If you're here today, why don't you come? Praise God, there's a brother coming right now. Come on, give God some praise today. Brother Allen, praise God for you. There's somebody else who's here today. Come on, why don't you press your way, press your way, press your way.
Oh, come to the altar. The Father's arms are open wide.
Come on, they're putting the link right now. D2IC.org/join. Come on, be a part of what the Lord is doing.
The precious blood of Jesus Christ. Oh, come to the altar.
The altar.
The Father's arms
Forgiveness
was bought with
the precious
blood.
Beloved, there is no better time than to join right now, because the shepherd, the good shepherd, I'm just the under shepherd, but the good shepherd wants you to make your way back home. Amen. Let us go to the Lord in prayer. God, we thank you right now. We thank you, oh God, for all that you've done and all that you will do. God, continue to be with us. Continue to bring your sheep, oh God, back to this fold. And God, we look forward to giving your name the praise. And God, we thank you for caring for us during this season. In your name we pray, oh God. Amen. Come on and stretch out your hands and say with me, life is better when we what? Dare to imagine.
Oh, Lord.